From the time I was a child in the 1970s, the name Bob Ingle was always spoken with great respect. In Western North Carolina, most of us worked at least one summer job at Ingle's. Many of our classmates' parents also worked there. The Ingle's, as it was called, was a fixed point of reference, a community meeting spot, a place you fixed up to go to because of course you would see someone you knew. After high school, I moved away to an area without an Ingle's. I've shopped in lots of different grocery stores over my 40 or so years of life. When I returned to Western North Carolina this year, I was encouraged by the changes and transitions Ingle's has made over the years. From locally grown organic produce to many of the larger organic brands, Ingle's has shown a dedication to its customers to find and supply the types of foods they want. There has always been a great love and respect for Bob Ingle's efforts to ensure fresh quality food products. This was an Ingle's commitment before it was fashionable and before local customers began demanding organic, sugar-free, hormone-free, gluten-free, and other specialty products you might expect to find only at health food stores. I grew up on food from Ingle's. When I read that Bob Ingle died yesterday, March 7th, it spoke to the heart of my Southern upbringing and heritage. Ingle's operates 203 stores in 6 Southern states and employs more than 18,000 people. Bob Ingle did more than supply food. His business helped sustain our local economy. For that, we should all be grateful. I want to thank Bob Ingle for all of his contributions to the many wonderful Southern meals that have been cooked for all these many years all over the South. His stores have shaped how I feel about food and cooking. Mr. Ingle, we appreciate all your hard work and commitment to quality. You will be missed, but not forgotten. You always seem to know who your customers were and what they needed.